passing over, and it feels like a dream. I could run and look for shelter, but you hold on to me. I'm under your skies, I'm caught in your eyes. Don't you know you stop the room, and all that I can see is you. I'm standing where the lightning strikes. I know this doesn't happen twice. You must be my once in a lifetime, in a lifetime. You must be my once in a lifetime. There's so much that I have told you, but it's all in my head. Ask me anything you want to, 'cause the answer is yes. I'll spend my whole life just being caught up in your eyes. Oh. Don't you know you stop the room? And all that I can see is you. I'm standing where the lightning strikes. I know this doesn't happen twice. You must be my once in a life.
What's up?
You look beautiful.
Hi.
We're getting married. You look great.
You look amazing. Look at this.
Look at that.
Look at that.
Look at that. You look awesome.
So do you.
Hey. You ready?
Oh, yeah. Okay. I like that.
Thank you.
The cool. Lavender looks really nice.
It smells good.
Oh, I can't cry.
Don't cry. You're not allowed to. You can't. Not yet.
Not yet.
Not yet. All right.
Hey. guys, welcome. We've been taking pictures for a while now, but it's really getting started. And I just want to welcome everybody here. And so the tour portion for this week, huh? Shoftim. And when the Israelites were back in the desert. Yeah, you're supposed to interrupt now.
I'm waiting for Jesse.
Jesse?
Yeah,
that's what we got. It's all about the laws. Getting the laws, understanding the laws.
What's the parsha?
The parsha. So about those laws. They had the laws. Good. They had to understand the laws.
Tell me them laws.
I don't know the laws by heart, but I know there were laws. And they got into Israel, and something happened.
Oh,
Okay, three more.
I'm counting.
Okay, last time.
Ceremony uniting the Hatan and the Kala, the groom and the bride, is composed of two parts, the erusin, the betrothal ceremony. And in this part, Darian will become consecrated to her beloved Gabe for the purpose of soon uniting together. And the ceremony concludes with the nisuin. Here the actual of uniting is effected through the seven blessings, the Sheva Brachot under the chuppah. The wedding canopy, the chuppah that we stand under, is representative of the home that you will build together. Rabbi Goldfez and friends of the Chatan and Kala. And I'll have in mind, each of you will take a sip of wine at the conclusion of the bracha. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech olam, borei pri hagafen. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech olam, asher kitshanu v'mitzvosav, v'tzivanu al ha'arayos, v'asar lanu es ha'harusos, v'hitir lanu es ha'nusuos, lanu al yidei chupa v'kidushin. Baruch atah Adonai, mekadesh amo Yisrael, al yidei chupa v'kidushin.
Amen.
This ring is owned by you. So it looks like it's a Shabbat Proton.
Yeah.
Okay. You're going to repeat after me. You're a righty. Okay, so you're going to extend your right index finger. You're going to hold the ring in your right hand. You're a righty?
I'm a lefty.
You're a lefty. Hold the ring in your left hand. Okay. Hooray.
Hooray.
You're marrying her, not me.
Oh. That's a good point.
Okay. Haray.
Haray.
At.
At.
Mikudesha.
Mikudesha.
Li.
Li.
Betabat.
Betabat.
Zo.
Zo.
Kedat.
Kedat.
Moshe.
Moshe.
The Israel.
The Israel.
Behold.
Behold.
You are consecrated.
You are consecrated.
Unto me.
Unto me.
With this ring.
This ring.
According to the laws.
According to the laws.
Of Moshe.
Of Moshe.
And Israel.
And Israel.
Okay. At this point, Rabbi Goldfez will read the ketubah, In Hebrew. You're gonna have to read loud.
I know. בבולטימור מטה שבמדינת מרילנד, איך החתן גבריאל מורדכי בן חיים ורבקה אמלה להדה בתותה, לאה בת מורדכי וחנה יהודית, הבדל נעים תוקידות משה בישראל וענה יפלח ואוביל ואיזון, ופאנס ואחי ואחי כתחות גוברים יהודאים,
בפרטים ומורדים וזמן וכנסים
חדן ראשון. ואם לא לכי, מוהר בתולייכי כזה זוזי מתון תחוזי לכי מדורייתו, או מזונייכי וכסטייכי וספחייכי, או מעל הבתייכי כאורה כל הרע. וסביית מרד לאה בתול תודה ועבוד ללאינטו ודין נדוניה דעדת לב מפי אבוה בין בכסף, בין בזהב, בין תכשיטין במונה דירושה בשימוש הדירה או בשימוש הדעסה הכל כבר עליו גבריה ומורדכי חתן דנן במאה זכורים כסף שרוף וסבי גבריה ומורדכי חתן דנן ואוסיף לה מן דילי עוד מאה זכורים כסף שרוף אחרים כנגד נסך הכל 200 זקוקים כסף שרוף, וכך אמר גבריאל מורדכי חתן דנן, אחראי על שטר כתוב דודו נדוני הדין ותוסיף דודו. רבות הדלי ועל ירתי בטרוי, לתפור המיקור שופר הרג נכסים, וקניון אינדף לתחות כל שמיו, דקנוי ודעותי דענו למכלאיו, ובנכסים דעתו אחראי דודת מאחראי על כולו נכרואי, וערבוין לתרום מנהון שטר כתוב דודו נדוני הדין ותוסף דודו. מנאי ואפילו מן גנימו דעת כתפי, וחיו ואתראי חיה מן יומו דינן ולעולם. ואחראיות בחומש שטר כתוב דודו נדון הדין ותוסף דודו, דבל עולם גבריאל מורדכי חתן דינן, כחומר כל שטרי כתובות, תוסף דוד דינאי ביונות ישראל העשויים כתיקונן, חכמינו זכרנו לברכה, בדרך כאסמכתא ובדרך כתוסף זה שטרי. וקנינה מן גבריאל מורדכי בן חיים ורבקה חתן דינן, למורד לאה בת מורדכי חנה יהודית בטולטה, ויהודית דבורה בטולטה, על כל מה דכתוב ומפורש באל במונה דכושר מחיה בה, והכל שרי וחיים. נאום דניאל יעקב בן רב ברוך
יצחק.
רב יצחק.
צבי.
צבי הכהן עד. נאום עמנואל בן חזקאל. איזה ראינו. רב בן חזקאל עד. מה זאת?
יצחק ברוך. Joe, can you land this on there? Yeah. Thank you. I want to share with you a secret. Can everyone hear me in the back? Can you hear me back there? Great. Okay. That's not the secret. This is not a marriage. Believe it or not, this is not a marriage. In Judaism, in Torah, there's no actual word for marriage. What we have, as we said at the beginning of the ceremony, is kiddushin, consecration, sanctification, and nisuin, which literally means to uplift, to lift up. The ketubah document that Rabbi Goldfez just read outlines numerous commitments that you made to each other. Yet nowhere in the entire document, in the legal document of the ketubah, nowhere is there a mention of the word love. According to Rabbi Yosef Dov Soloveitchik, the concept of love is nevertheless permeated in the text of the ketubah. See, because our sages understood that the word love is a commitment to action rather than a mere emotional feeling. The greatest expression of love is to make a commitment to one another, to do something positive and beneficial for each other. And it doesn't have to be materialistic. Sometimes it is. But it can also be accomplished by giving time or attention, but it always requires commitment. And in our tradition, Kiddushin, a Jewish marriage, is all about commitment. It's about each of you asking yourself, what can I do to demonstrate my love for my spouse? How can I show greater respect and honor for him or for her? And this type of relationship is much more complex than a lot of times people think of marriage as being a relationship of compatibility, right? That implies I'm good for you as long as you're good for me. This is a different type of relationship. Compatibility was great up until this moment, but what's going to make your marriage great from this point onward is commitment. You shared with me when we met, and it was really nice. Gabe sent me an email a few weeks ago reviewing, because he knows I have academic accommodations, so reviewing much of what we discussed when we met together, about how you met and how your relationship grew. Don't worry, it won't rain until the rabbi's done. I hope. And what was really beautiful is that this marriage today, this is really the culmination of a very healthy and supportive friendship. A friendship that grew and was fostered over time. A friendship where you supported each other when each of you needed strength. Whether it was getting into graduate school, whether it was getting placement following graduate school, whether it was at any time either one of you had certain worries or certain anxieties, the other one of you would be the rock for the other. And I thought it was so beautiful how you described that. Also, how you described in this week's Torah portion, this passage Torah portion of Re'eh, the notion of the marriage being, in a sense, a microcosm of the nation. And in fact, in Judaism, the family is the most basic cell of the nation. What goes on in Jewish homes forms the strength of the nation. The Rambam Maimonides makes a comment in Pirkei Avot, our sages teach us, Kinei Lecha Chaver, that a person should acquire a friend. And Maimonides describes three types of friendships. One, ohev toelet. This is a mutually beneficial relationship. No one wants to go bowling alone. Do kids still bowl nowadays? Or is it an app? I don't know. So you don't want to do things alone. So, Abdo, you're not in my class anymore, but still, you still have to listen to me.
Called out.
So, I miss you, man.
I'm here.
So, I know, I can hear you. Meanwhile, back to the chuppah. So the first type of friendship is ohev toelet. This is where you don't want to be alone, you have companionship. The second type of friendship is ohev menucha, where you offer comfort to each other, a sense of security, where you can tell one another anything about yourself and you're not worried about the other person judging you. They will still love you either way. And then Maimonides describes the third type of friendship, ohev ma'ala. Here, literally, it means a friendship that uplifts, where you can learn from each other, where there's a shared dedication to a noble or lofty goal, where there's a united sense of purpose, a joining of dreams. And when I was younger, I used to think that these are just three different categories of friendship. And now I've come to realize that these are actually three progressive stages of friendship. Now, some friendships don't go beyond that which is compatible, mutually beneficial. Some can go to the ohev menucha, to a type of relationship where you give one another a sense of security. But the friendship that the two of you have fostered with each other, I truly believe, is an ohev ma'ala. Your friendship has grown to one that it's not just about compatibility, it's not just about supporting one another, but it's about pulling together, striving for a higher goal, recognizing that there is something that only the two of you can achieve together with each other that neither one of you could achieve on your own. And I think that that is why there's no such thing as marriage. This is not just a legal procedure where two parties join together, but it really is nisuin. It really is one where you lift one another up. I want to close with a story about a wise man who speaks to a newlywed couple, and he points, it was an outdoor chuppah like this, and he points to the seashore, and he talks about these young children who build sandcastles on the beach near the shore. And these are elaborate structures, and they have high walls, and they're protected by moats. But at the end of the day, the tide comes in, and it utterly destroys these sandcastles. Nevertheless, the wise old man says, but the beauty of it all is that love's labor is never lost for these children. The next day they are at it again, repeating what has been broken, committed to rebuilding once again. A few moments from now, you're going to break the glass at the end of this ceremony. And there's different reasons for this custom, for this minhag of breaking a glass, but I wanted to share just one. A glass is fragile. It needs to be handled with care. It can easily chip and crack. Too much pressure or trauma and it will break. But even if that glass breaks, if you take the time, if you have the commitment and put forth the effort, and you add the right combination of skill and patience, that broken glass can be melted and refashioned again. Darian and Gabe, both of you are very compatible, and getting married is no-brainer. But my hope and my wish and my prayer to you is that you should build your marriage not on compatibility, but commitment. That you should have a great marriage where you have the resolve and the aspirations to renew your hopes and resurrect your dreams time after time, even after setbacks. And every day, the tides of the world might wash away and try to chip away at this love. And hopefully, every day you'll rebuild it with the fierce commitment and determination of those young children. Mazel tov.
Amen. Amen.
Who's doing the explanation of the Shabbat Brachot?
I'm right here.
Marie's right here.
Yeah.
One here.
They're right here?
One.
Holly and Jeremy and Perla. Holly. Yeah. Jeremy.
Holly. Perla. Jeremy.
Yep.
We're going to... Mary. We'll have a brief explanation of the Sheva Brachot, and then the service will conclude with the recitation of the seven blessings.
Expresses thanksgiving to God and allowing us to this joyous moment. Implicit in the blessing is the prayer that God will always be with Darian and Gabe, particularly in time and need. The third blessing reflects the miracle of birth, of being of Darian and Gabe, and distinct and unique people.
Feels before marriage, as close as Darian and Gabe have been to their family and friends. They reach out of share each other, destiny, and individuals we endure together, we can flourish.
In the fifth blessing, we pray that Darian and Gabe be endowed with family and children. This is the ultimate statement of love and continuity that transcends our own lives.
The sixth blessing expresses the hope that with family, Darian and Gabe be as joyous as Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, embodied all the love of the world. Similarly, beneath the chuppah, no love can be compared to Darian and Gabe's. Finally, the seventh blessing is a prayer for Jerusalem. Darian and Gabe commit themselves to Jerusalem, its people, its land, and its purpose.
So before Shabbat Bracha, according to your minhag, you're going to make a blessing, a bracha on the talit. Hold on.
Asher,
Kitchano,
the Mitzvotov, the Tivano, Lehit Atef, Lehit Atef, Batitit. Okay, I'm going to put it on. You'll wrap it around. Oh, sorry. Baruch, Atah, Adonai, Hello, Melech, Ha'olam, Shehechiano, Vikiyamano, Vihigiano, Lazman, Hazeh. Thank you very much. Okay, you're going to put on the tali, and then you're going to share it with your wife, just like he's going to share everything. Just before the Sheva Brachot, you are going to hand the ketubah to your wife. So you formally take possession of this. Then we'll put it back on the easel and we won't make you hold it. Okay. And this has to be with you wherever you are. Don't lose it, ever.
Thank you very much.
This is
for my dad.
Oh, your father. Oh, beautiful. Oh, great. Terrific.
Bore peri hagefen.
Amen.
Number two.
Rabbi, go places.
Go places.
He called an audible.
Rescue your friends.
We're going to come. Fresh
number two.
Wait, do you have Shachal Baruch? Yes. Okay, loud.
Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Shachal Baruch Lichvodoi.
Amen.
Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Yoter Adam.
Amen.
Amen.
Keep going.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher bara sason v'simcha chatan v'kala gila rina ditza v'chedva ahava v'yachava v'shalom v'reyot mehera Adonai Eloheinu yishma b'yare Yehuda v'chutzot Yerushalayim kol sason v'kol simcha kol chatan v'kol kala Mitzalot chatanim mechupatam unearim mimishteni ginatam Baruch ato Adonai mesameach chatan im hakala.
Amen.
Okay, Mom, you're going to give. Darian, sit. Steady. Just before we conclude the ceremony, we've called a few audibles up here today, but Gabe had a special request.
So I'm just going to read part of our ketubah.
You've got to stand here.
Oh, okay. Sorry. You are my inspiration, my champion, my lover, and my best friend. For all the days of my life, I will encourage you and delight you, love and support you. Together we will form a family and share our triumphs and our sorrows. Our home will be full of light and love, open to all whom we may meet along the way. My beloved, my sweet one, I will always be true.
Beautiful. Mazel tov! I can take this for you.
Thank you.
This is a great brother. Darian, mazel tov.
Thank you. That was great. Great.
Great to be here. Really, what an honor.
Out of the corner of my eye, caught you walking by. I chased you down. Is it okay if I call you mine from here on out? 'Cause I could never stop. You are light as a butterfly, heavy as a rock, from the bottom and the top. Is it okay if I call you mine from here on out? So if I could ever stop. Now I'm open up, I am strong and wild, like a storm in the star of my blood. And it's all because of you, you my love. Is it okay if I call you mine from here on out? I could never stop. When you laugh, it's like a light that fills me up. 'Cause you are my love. When I fell into your eyes, I could not get out, and I couldn't get enough. Is it okay if I call you mine from here on out? 'Cause I could never stop. And I want you to know, taking you apart like the stars of love in my blood. because of you. You are my love. Is it okay if I call you mine from here on now? I could never stop. Thank you.
happen. At this time, we're going to ask you to please find your seat, start to enjoy that first course of yours. We have some very special people who are going to say a few words to you.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam Amotzi Lechem Min Haaretz.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Borei Pri Hagafen.
What I want to do is something a little bit more significant just than saying thank you to everybody.
There you go.
I want to say something more significant than just saying to thank you to everybody for being here. You know, we thank you from the bottom of our hearts. But I really want to do something more significant. In the Gemara, which is the, they talk about God. God in heaven, he likes to marry people. He likes to marry souls. And he marries them in heaven, and they become one. And then some of those souls want to have a little bit of a challenge, and he sends them to earth. But what he does is he splits them in two. But it's not a straight line. It's like more like a puzzle kind of line. And then he sends them to earth. And he sends them at a different time. He sends them to different cities. But it's all within the plan of those souls eventually coming together. So we have two souls wandering in the world, yearning for completion. That's why opposites attract. You know, some people marry introverts with extroverts. In this case, we have a very easygoing guy, Gabe. Everything is cool, no problem, you know. Sure, you know, like cheeseburger in paradise. And then we have Darian. I mean, this is how I describe her in her bat mitzvah. She is a ball of energy. And she is like Hurricane Darian, category 5. And when they melt into one, they complement each other. And I have seen Darian going from a category 5 downgraded to a category 3. And Gabe still cheeseburger in paradise. Eventually he'll become a occasional thunderstorm or whatever. Anyway, so I really wrote a different speech, but it was taking about 20 to 30 minutes, so I decided to cut it down. So, you know, you guys are about to begin an amazing, unbelievable journey, married life. You stop being a man and a woman and become a husband and wife. There is a difference, which you will understand later during this speech. We first have to define terms. Love is an emotion that you feel when you focus on the virtues of another person and you identify them with those virtues. Love is something you choose. You choose to love somebody or you choose not to love them. Marriage is predestined, okay? The Jewish definition of marriage is very, very easy. It's one, oneness. It's the melting into souls, of two souls into one. Anyway, so our rabbis say that God invented marriage. It is a divine idea. It's not human. It's asking someone to be more than human. God is asking us to be godly, to be divine, and to be bigger than ourselves. You are here to make each other's lives better, easier, and more pleasant. We all have a long list of qualities, virtues, and good things about us that we may rarely use. How often do you have to be tolerant, to be forgiving, to be empathetic? How often do you have to sacrifice your comfort and needs for someone else? If you're not married, hardly ever, but when you're married, every good quality you possess, you will have to use it day in and day out. So how do you do this? Here's some advice that your mom and I would like to give you that we wish somebody had given us when we got married. Learn how to love each other. Do you think you love each other? You have no clue. You can't compare the love your mom and I had for each other on our wedding night to the love we have now. After 4 children, the loss of our fathers, our sister, all the challenges we've been together, it's like a joke. We had no idea. We knew we were up to something. We had no clue what was going to happen. So learn how to love each other. Learn how to argue and solve differences. Never humiliate yourself. Never step down on each other. Never yell at each other. It is the perfect recipe for disaster. When there is a difference in opinion, each side thinks that they are right. Each side believes they hold the truth. In the Hebrew language, the word emet, which is spelled A-M-T, means the truth. It starts with Aleph, the first letter of the alphabet, and ends with Taf, the last letter of the alphabet. In the middle is Mem, M, the middle letter of the alphabet. In an argument, one is Aleph, the other one is Taf, in complete opposite. The truth is for each other to go towards the middle and find the Mem, the truth. Give like crazy. Give more, and if you think you have given enough, just give more. That was in Abdo's speech. And yes, according to the Kabbalah, the book of Jewish mysticism, humans as opposed to animals are made of two parts, the physical part and the neshama, the soul, the spiritual part. It is said that we are created in the image of God. Our rabbis explained that God gave us a part of himself in our souls for the purpose of being godly. God is a giver, so for us to be godly, we need to be givers, not takers. And you're too young to know this, but when we have babies, God teaches us a very good lesson. Little babies, they don't do anything. They just sit there, they sleep. We have to feed them. We have to burp them. We have to do everything for them. And we don't expect anything from them. We don't get anything from them except for some throw up in our back and maybe diarrhea in our lap. But that's it. Diarrhea. Okay. So in marriage, math doesn't make any sense. If each one of you gives 50%, it doesn't become 100%. It becomes zero. It doesn't work. But when you give 100%, it doesn't become 200%. It becomes one, the melting of two souls. So give like crazy, give more. And if you think you have given enough, just give some more. Give above and beyond. Love and respect each other. At least in our generation, men need to be respected and women need to be loved. Men want love but need to be respected. Women need love but want to be respected. So give love and respect to each other. Embrace each other's challenges and learn from them. Your virtues are just the cherry on the top. You have to learn from your challenges and embrace them. No TV on the bedroom. Don't ever allow the TV on the bedroom. A child is conceived between the partnership of God, husband and wife, not husband, wife, and Jay Leno. Don't ever give up on each other, no matter what. I'll be done soon, guys. Don't ever give up on each other, not at all. Whatever happens, just stick together. When you have children, you don't give up for your children. You just love them no matter what. Whatever they do, whatever they say to you, you just love these kids. And you just don't give up on them. You don't hear, you're disrespectful, your room is messy, I'm going to divorce you, and I'm going to find a divorce kid lawyer to divorce us, and that's it. And then I'm going to go on kid J-Swap or Tinder, whatever you guys do, and I'm going to find a new baby, a new child that is going to be respectful, and maybe he'll be better looking than you. You don't do that. So if you don't give up on your children, you don't give up on your spouse, on your partner. Yes, you may say, yeah, it's a different type of love, but yes, I agree. Your kids are physically yours. They have your DNA, the whole nine yards. But I have news for you. Their soul don't belong to you. The soul belongs to somebody else. And eventually, they will spend their life for eternity with them. So giving up on your spouse is giving up on eternity. Don't do that. If you're going to be with somebody for eternity, you might as well make the best out of it. And live your life happy life. Don't worry about existence. Existence without life, without a purpose, just takes space in this world. And find your personal paradise. You haven't been married long enough, but those who have, you remember, when you have a long day of work and you go to your kids' room and they're sleeping, you say, wow, it doesn't get any better than this. When you are later on in life, when you're at a Shabbat table, and you see your kids, the values that you have given them, how successful they are, the people that they chose to marry, and you say, wow, it doesn't get any better than this. When you walk into a restaurant with no wall, no windows, no view, and you're sitting in front of your spouse, and you look at her and you say, wow, the view from here is amazing. There is nowhere I would rather be. That is when you find your personal paradise. So work hard to find your personal paradise. Yeah. Gabe and Darian, have a happy and prosperous life together. Or as Mr. Spock said, live long and prosper. Raise a beautiful family with all the values and traditions we have given you. And remember, life is not measured by the amount of breaths we take, but by the moments that take our breath away.
All right, you can keep those applause going. Because it's now time to hear from Gabe's parents, Rennie and Bill Willis.
We just like to say we'd like to say welcome to all of our friends and family from far and near, because they're people from all corners of the earth. We thank you, Allison and Marco, for this wonderful party. We also welcome Darian to our family, who have grown to know and love. And we also welcome Sawyer. It's nice to have the pitter-patter of tiny feet in our house. Soccer has been a recurring theme in bringing these two together. Gabe was playing adult soccer with Abdo in D.C. on a visit. And Abdo suggested Gabe contact Darian in Israel. He contacted her when he got back to Tel Aviv, and the rest is history. However, many years ago, both our family and the Rothys sat only seats apart at RFK for DC United matches. Little did we know at that time that we would be here celebrating with the same folks today.
Our first inkling that Darian was a very important person came when I was making travel plans for my annual visit to Gabe in Israel in late 2016. He made a request, make sure you stay long enough so that you can meet Darian when she returns from her visit in Barcelona. Needless to say, I followed those instructions, and in early 2017, I met Darian in Tel Aviv. It was clear to me then that the stars were aligned. Darian, we love you and are delighted to have you join our family. It has been a joy to get to know you better. You are a great housemate. We love your cooking. And we will be forever grateful to you for bringing Gabe back from Israel. Darian and Gabe, your future is bright. We look forward to celebrating with you again and again and again, and we wish you a lifetime of love and joy.
Oh, I'm Gabby.
And I'm Vicky.
We are Darian's older sisters. And as her older sisters, it is always our duty to embarrass her and poke fun of her. So we are going to do a little bit of that tonight. But we are also very floored by the woman who's standing in front of us today, marrying Gabe. And so we're going to tell you a little bit about their love story. But first, we need to mention that although Gabe and Darian did not want a hashtag for this wedding, we had to do it. It's hashtag Gabe's Got Diarian. So a few weeks ago, we went into Darian's room looking for inspiration for this speech. And Mom has been begging us to clean out our closets in our old bedrooms to make space for even more of her slightly used dresses. But this time, our collective laziness paid off when we found this bin behind all of Mom's cupcake dresses in Darian's closet. And it is filled with memorabilia from Darian's life, and more importantly, for the reason that we're all here tonight, the story of Darian's quest for love.
In the bin, we found the Outstanding Person Award from high school, countless love letters from friends and former students whose lives you've touched, and empty bags of Mexican candy, which you devoured. We even found a note from our pop-up addressed to the four of us. It was full of jokes like reminding Abdo to take a shower, because he often forgot, and finished with how much he loved each and every one of us. When he was still sick, you were just a little girl, and you tended so thoughtfully to his every need. Though he passed too soon, he simply would not have recovered and lived as long as he did if it weren't for your love and commitment that you showed him during your most trying months, his most trying months. So on to some of the more priceless items from Darian's quest for love.
So here we've got a picture of proof, pipe cleaners and glitter. From Darian, age 4, anything for love. Way back when, us older sisters would get our kicks by painting Darian's body in neon makeup and sparkles, put her in the most absurd outfit, and attach pipe cleaners to her hair. All in preparation for her to be our human sacrifice. Followed by a wedding ceremony to Abdo. Darian didn't question it. But at that point, we knew that she really would do anything for love. And we also knew that Vicky and I would be great cult leaders.
Colin Farrell tissue box. Age 10, Darian's first love. This was it. At age 10, Darian found her true love, Colin Farrell. She loved him so much that she covered this tissue box with his face, carried it everywhere with her. We, us siblings, have always helped Darian on her quest for love. So we got in touch with Colin Farrell and convinced him to send her a piece of his hair. The day his hair came in the mail, addressed to Darian Alexandra, the love of my life, we've never seen Darian more happy. Sorry, Gabe. Little did she know, this love was rooted in deceit. Colin Farrell hair? Yeah, right. More like sweaty Jesse Hurwitz hair after an impromptu workout on the roof of our house. Gabe, are you featured on a tissue box? Well, here you go. We did Darian the service of making one with your face all over it.
The next item is the Snooki dress. Age 19, dressed to impress. As college rolled around, Darian grew up into a beautiful woman and was more ready than ever to find the one. She developed her own style, hoping to attract the perfect mate. Some people call it peacocking. Triple high heels, stick straight hair, tan on tan, with 50% off clothes, and not the price. This Darian was confident and strong and sure to meet her Prince Charming, especially when she rocked what we affectionately dubbed the Snooki dress.
Israeli passport, age 22, finding herself and finding her Besheret. I want to find myself, Darian told us. This led Darian to Israel. Visas, a journal, speech pathology coursework, and an open heart all in hand as she boarded the plane. No matter who gets credit for setting Darian up with Gabe, side note, it was me. Darian, when you met Gabe, you knew right away that he was the one. Darian found herself and found her true love in Israel. Someone she could be her full self with, someone that saw all of these stories that made Darian who she is and fell in love with each and every one of them.
All right, this is Darian's childhood diary. From when she was 11 years old, her own love story. So last but not least, we did find this gold mine, her childhood diary. We wanted to respect her privacy, but some of the stuff is just too good not to share. Darian has been giving herself love advice since she was a little girl, and we thought that, Gabe, we would share with you, in Darian's own words, some advice for your marriage.
January 20th, 2004. This is love. I gave my boyfriend a pair of my socks, and he gave me a ring.
February 14th, 2004. I have a Valentine. He gave me a Beanie Baby.
May 17th, 2004. I like blank and he likes me. He asked me to be his girlfriend and I said yes. Colin Farrell is so hot. But blank is a tad hotter. It's a secret, but Alana knows. I have a pic of Colin Farrell in my locker and I kiss it every day.
August 13th, 2004. This is a poem, I think. Love is beautiful. When spring comes, love comes. When winter, fall, and summer come, love is with it. Be happy, don't give up. Love is as fragile as your heart. Stay in love. My name reminds me of flowers on a sunny day.
Darian, as we sifted through these items, reminiscing about you, it dawned on us that you are no longer the adorable, curly-cued, panting, sweet-eyed troublemaker. You are now a woman, confident and radiant, reflective, defiant, giving, and with Gabe in your life, you've grown into your best self. You don't just believe in yourself, but believe in us by pushing us both to be the best versions of ourselves.
While we can't count how many times we've seen Darian walk into a room and thought, who is that girl? She's beautiful. Only to realize, that's my reflection. I mean, my sister. What is on the outside complements what's within. Darian, you are magnetic. You radiate an energy full of kindness, passion, and love. Gabe, you are grounded and confident, intelligent, and you don't waver in your values. Most importantly, you love Darian for who she is, and we love you, Gabe. You are the one that Darian has hoped and dreamed for her whole life. You are the hero, the fibers, the magic, the past, present, and future of her love story.
Mr. and Mrs. Willis, together your love is calm and real and absolute. Your love consists of accepting one another for exactly who you are and being present in every moment of the love you share. Your love is confident and it triumphs and it has no excuses and no boundaries. Your love consists of two reciprocal processes, being loved and being loving. It's your love, Darian and Gabe Willis, love.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to hear from your best man, Aaron. Let's hear it for Aaron.
If you watch movies, primarily for cheap laughs and awful character development, as I do, you've seen several of what I'll call the dad comedy genre. A favorite plot in these movies is to gather 30 or 40 something friends to reminisce about the lifetime of awesome things they almost did. The foil to their greatness, always, is a hurdle that has been minimized to nothing over time, but was in fact fundamental. For example, we've all heard, I could have been in the majors if I'd stuck it out, but that kid quit after kid pitch. Unlike just about everyone in the room, not least me, Gabe can sit around with his buddies in 10 years with four kids and talk about the awesome things he actually did. A couple stories. So playing college sports is the realistic pinnacle for most youth sporting careers. My brother Gabe declined an actual Division I soccer offer, and suburban parents everywhere have yet to recover. It takes supreme confidence in yourself and a clear focus on the end goal to pull that off. Gabe, instead, he went to Pitt, and he bet on himself to walk onto the varsity team. And he bet on himself to walk onto the varsity team at the hardest roster position. And he made his bet with the shoulders of an arthritic 93-year-old. But he did it. He got the official swag to prove it. And you may not all know this, he was an academic all Big East in the process. Gabe also spent 2 years in the Israeli army. As I understand the IDF, there are job nicks. They're around-the-clock types. Roughly the 9-to-5s, whatever. So Gabe chose the round-the-clock route. Instead of the office, he decided to go crawl around in the desert, sleep in the holes, live for a week on water and matzah. You get the idea. It sounded terrible then, and it sounds terrible now. But to Gabe, it was the only choice. Being a combat intelligence soldier was the way he intended to do the army. It was not, however, how his arthritic 93-year-old shoulders intended to do the army. Nevertheless, a lifestyle that's beyond the pale for most of us, and he was perpetually in a good mood about it. To this day, it's not clear to me he understood what it was they were yelling at him about. These things might be related. In any event, joining any military requires fortitude and commitment. Doing so far from family and friends and the culture you know requires a leap of faith. And doing so in a language you barely speak is bananas. But Gabe, you did all of that. And for that, I offer my gratitude and my admiration. And I also want to ask all the folks here who served in the IDF to just stand. I want to thank you guys, too. All right. Darian, my brother has never taken the easy fork in the road, and he's got an excellent track record choosing the more complicated path. In him, you found yourself a partner who will choose the right path for the right reasons, and will put everything he's got into succeeding. He will succeed. And while it's possible a Willis brother might be stubborn along the way, please forgive him, I promise he means well. Gabe, you've collected a varied and impressive set of experiences in your 28 years on Earth. And when you're 38 or 58 or 78, I know you'll look back without wondering what might have been. While your friends may one day talk about the story they never really had, you'll tell them about soccer and about the army and about your expert kibbutznik cowherding skills. You'll also tell them that the best experience wasn't any of those, but the one here today with Darian. And as you two build the next set of experiences as co-conspirators in Atlanta or Mexico, or wherever else strikes the mood, your movie will be much, much more exciting than the dad comedies. As Marco said on Friday night, cheers, salud, l'chaim.
We'll be right back.
Now we'd like to ask Gabe and his mom up to the dance floor.
Thank you. No, you good?